Learning the game is pretty much what our channel and our website is all about. And there are a ton of things to learn in Ultimate and an infinite number of ways to get better. While it's hard to say what the best single way is to learn, we have some ideas. Obviously, one way to learn the game is to go on our website, ProGuides.com. We've got a lot of tips from the pros, a coaching platform that lets you get connected with good players, and even more character guides. So if there are some generally better ways to learn the game, are some characters better at learning the game? Well, yes and no. To decipher this contradiction, you have to understand how hard it is to learn fighting games. Before we dive into the topic and tell you what we think, I want to hear what you think. Our question of the day is, what character do you recommend new players to play? Go ahead and tell us down below and then continue to the video. We'll see if our answers match. Fighting games are one of the world's least friendly genres, at least in terms of learning and playing. And there are many reasons why. A lack of useful tutorials, an abundance of tight timing windows, underdeveloped AI, single player that just doesn't build the core skill of the game, and very, very bad netcode and matchmaking systems. All of these issues combine into one overarching problem, a steep and strange learning curve. A learning curve, sometimes called a difficulty curve, is a term that we use to talk about how smoothly a game introduces new challenges. A steep difficulty curve means that the game goes from being easy to hard very quickly. A steep learning curve is similar, but it means there's a point where learning needed skills will be suddenly noticeably more challenging. The learning curve in the fighting game is unpredictable and hard to manage because it relies on the human competition. Since the AI and the single player often can't sustain a player's growth, the player needs to find a human competition. But not just any competition will help them improve. In the world of language learning, there is something called the comprehensible input. Coined by linguist Stephen Krashen, comprehensible input is the level of language slightly beyond the learner's current level of competence. It's close enough to their comfort level that they can understand it using context clues or words that they already know. However, it's far out enough that it's challenging and they're hearing new words. This level of learning is what we call an I+1, and it's ideal for a lot of learning, not just language. Facing an opponent of the same skill level is usually the I+1 of fighting games. Some days they win, some days you win, most days you learn new ways to improve. However, in the world of fighting games, it's hard for you to find your I+1, your comprehensible input, or your just +1. So instead you end up fighting a mix of people, a strong veteran player online, I+10, the top player in your region, I+100, an actual pro, I+1000, your casual friend who's been grinding that sick new Animal Crossing game, that's an I-10, but hey, their island is basically a work of art. You can learn things from any of these players, at least if you have the right attitude and if they're trying to help you. But the best consistent training partner is that equal or slightly better player. On top of competition, you have to consider the character, because the character you pick will change your learning curve. If you're starting from scratch, outright low-tier characters like Little Mac and Kirby will seem deceptively good. They both have tools that work very well at the lowest level of skill. However, these players make the learning curve even steeper because they lack tools to handle even the mid-levels of skill. That's because Little Mac and Kirby can be very cheesy characters. They both have tools that can surprise an unprepared opponent and take a stock. However, when you learn how to play around these tools, they're not nearly as useful. So, in a sense, yes, some characters can help you learn the game, and they do it by smoothing out their learning curve. But what kind of characters are actually good at smoothing out their learning curve? In Smash, the learning curve is like a mountain, rising up and then plateauing, then rising up again. So you want a character that won't struggle along the different parts of the climb. First, you want a character that can function well at several skill levels. Another part of the learning curve comes from the character and not the competition. Some characters are flat out harder to play and require more effort to learn, making the learning curve even steeper. So, second, you want a character that doesn't have huge difficulty barriers. These requirements are pretty straightforward, but they are also pretty contradictory. For example, easy characters with no execution barriers and a lot of cheese often won't function well at several skill levels. On the other hand, some characters that do well at all levels do so at the cost of being difficult to learn their mechanics. Shulk's a great example of a character who meets the first requirements but fails at the second. He does well at all skill levels, but to master him, you're gonna have to learn tech like dial storage. And be honest with yourself, do you have that kind of time or patience? If you do, hey, you might just be a Shulk mate. And you're in good company because Shulk's a surprisingly popular character, maybe because he meets the first criteria. On top of these requirements, a lot of games, guides, and voices in the community will push another requirement, the fact that you guys are using ProGuides. Just kidding. That the character teaches good fundamentals. However, all characters can teach fundamentals and all characters benefit from good fundamentals. That's why they're called fundamentals. You don't need to play super honest, super bread and butter characters to learn the game's fundamentals. And there's not a lot of proof that honest characters will help improve your fundamentals over cheesy or one-dimensional characters. A lot of great Smash players have strong fundamentals despite playing characters that aren't super honest or well-rounded. Now that we've set down what makes some characters better at smoothing out the learning curve of the fighting game, you might notice that a handful of characters fit the bill. There are over 70 characters in Ultimate after all, and most are decent enough to win at least a small-sized tournament. So, going by character through the top 5 doesn't really make sense. Instead, here's a list of characters that we think are the best at learning the game. Wolf, Mario, Lucina, Palutena, and Inkling. This is the first part of the list, the more expected characters. Each one of these 5 characters are great in the current meta. They get results at all levels and have high play rates. Each character has a strong base tool that can carry them through low level skills, coupled with room for optimization that carries them smoothly into higher levels. Their optimizations are also somewhat easier to make. Cloud, Rob, Diddy Kong, Bowser, Mega Man, and Samus. Now this is the second part of the list, the hot take characters. You might not see these characters as good for learning because they're less balanced in their styles. Samus, for example, has a very strong advantage but very weak disadvantage. Other characters, like Mega Man, have super unique parts of their kit that won't transfer to other picks. But that doesn't matter. What matters is that each character here works at all skill levels and has an intuitive and accessible optimization path too. For example, Diddy Kong and Rob both have items that gradually unlock increasing complexity. You can go from simple zoning and stage control to killing at 20% from Rob or 0% with Diddy Kong. You can see from the whole list that it's not all about honesty and fundamentals or versatility or even difficulty. It's about how well you can grow with the character. And that's not all, is it? If you've been paying very close attention, you might have noticed that we've missed something so far. We missed the contradiction. The truth is, while some characters may help you learn the game, there's no true best character for learning the game. If you force yourself to play one of the characters above, you might do more harm than good. That's because of the simplest, most powerful factor behind all fighting games: fun. Fun is the reason you picked up Super Smash in the first place. The promise of having fun brings us to the game, and the actual fun of playing is what keeps us going. Not to mention, fun is one of the best motivators and learning tools in the world. Our brains don't retain and collect information as well when we're under stress. Stress puts up an effective filter, which limits the flow of information. This happens with languages too, which is why teachers often use songs or funny videos to teach phrases. And that's why a lot of cultures have an ingrained social habit of complimenting second language speakers for saying basically anything right. If the learning process is more fun, it moves faster and the learner stays motivated. Motivation is huge in fighting games because the learning curve is so tricky. If one option is to smooth out the curve itself, the other one is to keep your motivation high so you don't give up when things get tough. And the best way to do that is through having fun. But if you're looking to have even more fun, then what we talked about before isn't as important. What's more important is playing a character you like. And that's where the contradiction hits. That's the yes and no. Yes, some characters are better for learning the game because they smooth out the learning curve. But no, sometimes the character doesn't really matter as much because your own taste and what keeps you coming back to the game doesn't really align with the characters that we mentioned. Sometimes the best character for learning the game is just your favorite character. But fun isn't static either. How much fun most of us will have with a character will also depend on the competition. We have more fun when winning, so usually we like characters that we can win with. We have less fun when we feel like we can't improve with a character, so we usually go for characters with depth. This is why a lot of Ultimate players switch off characters they played at the start of the game. It's also why a lot of new players have a starter character that they eventually drop. Ganon might be fun in 4-player free-for-alls and early level competition, but he might become stale as he gets gimped and zoned to death. It's also why there's a big overlap between the best characters to learn in the game and the popular characters. Wolf, Palutena, Rob, Cloud, and Inkling are all popular in part because they smooth out that learning curve. For many players, the steep, weird learning curve of the fighting game isn't that fun at all, so characters that smooth the curve inherently feel more fun than those that don't. Picking the best character to learn with can be a battle between fun and practicality, but it can also be a fusion of the two. If being an incredible Kirby keeps you motivated, then he's great for learning the game. But if Kirby's flaws make the learning curve too steep, then there's no shame in changing mains. After all, you need to enjoy the game's learning process because it never really ends. To improve at the game, you've gotta learn. And that's why we're here to make these videos, and that's why you're watching them. And with that all being said, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and ring that notification bell for more videos such as this. Also, make sure to check out ProGuides.com if you want to improve your gameplay. I hope you guys are all staying healthy and staying safe. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys next time.